This is the spectacular Alpine town of Briançon, the highest fortified city in Europe.
Only about 20 kilometers from Italy, this beautiful spot has a long history. The high walls were built by Vauban, a clever French military engineer, more than 300 years ago. In the high valley, several farmers like Odile have a small herd of ewes producing milk for making original farmhouse cheeses, some of which are sold to Fabien, the promising young owner chef from La Table du Chazal restaurant in the local village of Les Guilbertes. On the outskirts of Briançon, Aline Roule's family has been producing fine hams and small goods for several generations.
Alors ici, on a la préparation pour faire des jambons crus. Donc le désossage, les porcs, on les a reçus ce matin.
Excess skin, fat and bones are carefully removed by the experienced charcutiers.
Donc ici, vous avez des jambons qui ont été mis au sel, donc dans des sacs sous vide. Ils restent comme ça 3 semaines. Et après, on les pend sur des échelles comme ça pendant une petite semaine avant de les mettre dans notre gros séchoir pour qu'ils finissent leur durée de séchage pendant 12 mois.
The ham is always better freshly sliced to a thickness of less than 1 millimeter.
Beautiful flavor, superb ham. Merci.
De rien.
At the local chef's college, Laurent Berrier teaches how to prepare tourton. It is made with an egg dough, garnished with mounds of vegetable mixture on half of the dough. The dough is folded over to create little parcels looking like ravioli. After a brief deep frying, the tourtons are served with wild dandelion leaves and ham. Another chef, Jimmy Saron, prepares oreille d'âne, a type of lasagna, named after a wild spinach with leaves the shape of a donkey's ear. As he makes it, he invites me to test it at his restaurant.
Very delicious vegetarian Alpine dish.
Next, I visit Karim from the distillery Des Boussardes, who makes mélèze, a liqueur made from pine buds. His alambic is similar to the one my great-grandparents used. I am curious to test it.
Ça c'est bon, ça, ça donne un coup de fouet.
Tomorrow I'm arriving in the stunning region of Provence to taste a delicious rosé and visit a great market.